It's the Czech Republic in red serving. It's Switzerland in white receiving. This is round two action from the FIVB Beach Volleyball four-star Cancun Hub event here in Mexico. And a place in the quarterfinals is what these two teams are playing for. And it's a long rally to get things going, which eventually goes the way of the Czech Republic. Slukova with the serve. Has a good jump serve on her. That was close to the baseline, but not close enough. Nina with the serve. It's a decent chase. It's so difficult to move on the sand at the best of times, but it's not like indoors where you can run in semicircles to get round to the ball, like it's how indoor volleyball's played. On the beach, your feet are slipping away from you, and you can see there's a side movement. You're trying to get round again, but mostly trying to get there with your body and bring your arm around the ball. All about moving in pretty much in straight lines on the beach, which means getting your angles right in defense really important. Running for the ball, this could leave unforced error from Slukova. Hermanova and Slukova's victory over Switzerland in the form of Anouk Verge-Dupree and Joanna Heidrich was the game on centre court here on day one. It's a big, big game. And quite an extraordinary change around in terms of how the game went as well, in terms of the sets. They lost that first set 19-21, but the turnaround in the second was quite incredible, 21-12. And then it was point for point for point in the third set. But the Czech Republic grinding out the result. And they'll feel pretty confident about this one going up against the lesser seeded Swiss pairing now. Even so, it doesn't mean that they'll be taking it any less seriously. They've actually played each other on numerous occasions of these two teams. It's Hermanova and Slukova who lead the series 4-3. The last time they played was in Moscow in 2019, and that was a victory for Hermanova and Slukova in three sets. 15-8 in the decider. Four of the seven encounters between these two have been three set matches. Yes! And right now, it's Switzerland who are getting off to a very good start. That ball not rolled high enough. Good timing in the block. Bara, as she's known, with the serve for Czech Republic. Touch with Slukova, this will come back into play. But not quite as was expected with that second touch. Slukova was trying to get herself into a good position, knowing that she was in front of Hermanova, but also then wanting that ball to get back in front of her, so she's coming off the net to try and then get around that ball to come and have an attack. But all that was rather moot as it went miles away from her. Yeah. Switzerland are doing really well in defence. They're getting lots of touches on the ball, making this court seem even smaller than the 8x8 that it is. You just wonder how much that will play on the minds of the Czech Republic, because at the moment, every time the ball's gone to the sand, there's been a hand on it. Very well placed, right into the corner. Sukova with no chance of going after that one. Once again, so that's really, you get a feeling of a product of the fact that Permanova trying to avoid the defender and has ended up with the unforced error of playing that one out. And Switzerland now with a 4-point lead. And the hustle from Switzerland really paying off. Great blocking. Switzerland playing brilliantly at the moment. And the timeout's been called by the Czech Republic. This isn't the start they were looking for. That's a wonderful block. Switzerland's outings here in this Cancun hub have been consistent. They were ninth in the first four-star event, they were ninth in the second, they also had a ninth in Doha, so it's three nines in a row for Switzerland. For the Czech Republic, they were 17th in Doha, they were 25th in the first event here in Cancun, and they were ninth in the second. So they've been steadily, well, certainly improving since the first Cancun event, but a bit of a mixed bag for them. For Switzerland, it's all about trying to get past this round two and make it into the quarters and then go past that again. Touch. As it landed in, there's a little bit of a check here because the ref wasn't sure. I would also argue, but I think it's out. That's pretty good sporting spirit between the two. Stakova's like, yeah, well, it's close, but I think it's out. It was pretty close, but sometimes it can appear in when that ball is so close and the sand splashes onto the line, give an appearance of it's caught the line. Right now, Stakova's not getting many good reads on what Switzerland are doing. Well, I'm not sure what Nina's doing with the ball. And Stakova hasn't really been on anything at all at the moment. Oh, great reactions from the Czech Republic. And again, this one's got to come back. I thought they caught in the block, but it didn't. However, it's unforced error from Stakova. So all of that hard work paying off for Switzerland in the end. Really good pickup. Not such a good finish. What a great touch. Yeah. Nina Betschart's definitely got the reading of Hermanova. She's the right side of the court. She's getting a hand on pretty much everything, which is why Switzerland are good for their lead. Add in a few unforced errors from the Czech Republic, and it's all going well for the team in white at the moment. good break from Hermanova, good touch, and this time Czech Republic come up with a break point, a point from service to get them a little bit closer to Switzerland. Cross court was the block, just a little late, or perhaps a little early, depending on how you look at it, probably a little early in the jump. Technical timeout, Switzerland still good for their lead. There's a cracking match also happening at the moment between USA's Alex Kleiman, April Ross and Kerry Walsh Jennings and Brooke Sweat. That will see decided which team will go into the quarterfinals. It's the 54th head-to-head meeting between Kerry and April. Kerry's won 37 of the 53 previous meetings, but April has won 8 of the last 9 matches, and it's a 5-match winning streak with April over Kerry. They actually played 45 events together, domestically and internationally. They had 23 titles, and they took just short of $1 million in earnings when they played together. They competed in 32 FIVB World Tour events, and they took 11 gold medals, $758,000 in earnings. Quite an incredible partnership they were, and now playing against each other. And that's the way of beach volleyball. Back to the action here on centre court. Switzerland with the lead by 5, but that's been whittled down by 1 due to that unforced error. To see the Swiss pairing are going after Barbara Hermanova, and the Czech Republic are going after Nina Betschart. Both teams feeling that those are the two players, the player that they can get points from, the team or the player that they can get the read on. Break. It's an important skill and a big skill to have as a blocker, and that's a great block, but the ability to know when to break and when to stay and force the issue can be and is decisive in matches. Initially it was a break which resulted in the continuation, and that time from Hubeli, it's the block that gets the point. That ball just going to outside the right hand of Hubeli, couldn't help herself but to try and get onto it. Classically just helping it on its way out, quite bring it back into play. It's a bit tight, too tight. And Manova gets the block. Deciding to stay back, and it almost worked. Might well have done if the ball hadn't clipped the net on the way through and changed the trajectory of it. But at the moment, not really showing anything to suggest that they are going to get back into this one. Getting their side out points. They've picked up a couple of break points. This is where they need to try and get something going. So They're going with line block against Hubeli, cross-court block against Betshark, but nobody there to stop that one. Czech Republic as well, Cam did the 50-50. So Sokova will go in and have a block as well as Hermanova. Serve. Really well played by Stokova to be able to get the side out. They were struggling a little bit in Czech Republic. The pokey called into action. With a rare error. Switzerland very much in system and able to have a really good swing, and the break from the Czech Republic probably in hindsight now wasn't the right thing to have done. Two cross-court blocks. Interesting that Switzerland called cross-court blocks but actually broke back on the line then. Which kind of makes sense because they knew where they were, and Betshark was in the cross-court position. So when they're starting in the cross-court to run to the line, so the break would always be to the line. Switzerland, we'll see how that pans out, whether I got that one right. It's well played, just enough of the fingers of Slukova to send it away from Hermanova. And now Switzerland, just two away from taking this opening set. Well played, very delicate touch that from Hermanova. Finding a range now, but earlier on in the set, that particular play was eluding her. Oh dear, well, it was a great touch to keep it in play, but not quite the touch that Hanyu was looking for. Well left. Set point for Switzerland, but Czech Republic definitely got a little bit of momentum towards the end of this set, which could well actually see them go on. You never know. No foregone conclusions. It's not over just yet. Switzerland still got to find the winning point. Well, they found it straight away. Touch day serve. That's a great way to end the set. Switzerland take it 21-17. But the Czech Republic certainly found their range and got right back into the set, losing the gap, but just a little too late in the end to have an impact on the set. We'll see how the second one pans out though as a result of that. Czech Republic serving to get the second set underway. Slipova with the ball. And a serve to forget from her. Lomonova just struggling at the moment with service reception. Gave up the point. That lost them the set. And has now given up a point straight away at the beginning of the second set. That's a tough one for Hubley. Great pickup from Nina. Question of whether to play that before it went into the net or not. Tried to play it before it's gone to the net, but it could see it was going to go under. Huge hit. If you allow a player to be able to hit cross court outside of your block and back into the middle, then you've got your block positioning wrong, you've called the wrong thing. Definitely a tactical error for the Czech Republic. A positional error certainly in the block to allow that to happen. Still looking good. Slipova not finding the line, not finding the block either. That's better for the Czech Republic. But at the moment, just a couple of side out points. And indeed, as Barbara says, let's go, let's go. They certainly need to get something going. I think that's more for herself than anything. That's a good serve. So important when receiving serve, even on the beach, that you have some forward momentum, not swinging your arms, but containing the ball ideally between your knees. You've got a nice strong base to play the ball from. And then it's the body movement forward, so you get that ball going to target. You just don't want to stand there, hold your platform and let the ball hit you. Look as if you're posing for a photo. That's when passing errors are made. It looks perfect when you're watching and you think, well, that looked great. Why did it go up and out of play? It's because you just actually let it hit you. Still want to give some forward movement to the ball. And if you watch the passes, you'll see that there is always that bit of movement to the ball. And also it helps them with continuing on to get into position to attack. It's a good comeback this by the Czech Republic, just one behind now.
Yes!
Make it all square. Now the errors are coming for Switzerland over the block, but unfortunately over the baseline as well. I mentioned earlier in the broadcast about the match between Sweat Welsh Jennings and Kleiman Ross of the All of the USA. They're on the same side of the bracket as these two teams, so the winner of this one will be playing the winner of Brooke Sweat, Welsh Jennings and Alex Klein and April Ross. Great blocking again by Switzerland. That's a great touch and really well held with the platform. Unfortunately for Slikova, she gets turned by the ball and could keep her platform back towards her partner, back towards the net. Just watch as she goes to the sand, looking at that, and then as one hand went down, the other arm still getting a good touch and bringing it back into play. That's the advantage of having a big blocker, because Slikova knew that she was in tight, knew the block would be there, so rolled it high, and that gave time for Bechart to then go and chase that ball down. Switzerland getting two good points to put them back in the driving seat in this second set. Looking at the draw as it stands at the moment, I mentioned the two teams that are on court here, and the winners will be playing the winners of the All-USA game. And then in the other part of the draw, in the top half, it's Sanne Kaiser and Madeleine Meppelink of the Netherlands. They're currently playing against Cuba's Echeverri and Sanchez. And then the other two teams are Artacho and Clancy of Australia and Wojciech and Kochilek of Poland. That's the top half of the draw. The bottom half of the draw, which you'll see one of the games from there coming up after this one, as that one has clipped the line, is an all-Brazilian affair. Talita Antunes and Tiana Lima of Brazil up against Agata Bednarczyk and Duda Lisboa. That game will be on after this one. The winners of that game will play the winners of Van Ursel and Ipma of the Netherlands against Stockman and Kolinsky of the USA. All four USA teams still in the draw here in Cancun, because at the bottom part of the draw, it's Clay Sponsel of the USA up against Borger Suda of Germany. And the winner of that one will be playing against Pavan and Humana Paredes of Canada against Margarazova and Kolomina of Russia. So some really tough teams still in this tournament. And the bottom half and top half of the draw, there's no easy matches at all. That is a wonderful cut. Right off the heel of the hand, just letting the ball bounce off of it. High enough, cutting across the body. When you're square onto the net like that, cutting across your body, you've got to make sure you take the ball the highest possible point, otherwise the net gets in the way. Technical timeout, just one separating the teams. A much different second set, very different second set to the first set, where there was a 5-point difference in Switzerland's favour. Not the case here in the second set.